Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Shafer here. So as you can see, I've gotten a lot of requests over the years to make an origami laptop. Most recently from Noam, with whom I had a tutoring session. So here it is. This is a rather simple model, and it's pure origami except for the keyboard, which I drew on because folding a keyboard would be insane. And what's really cool about this model is that since the screen is just one layer, if you add some backlighting, you can do an on-screen origami puppet show with twisty ties. The laptops close and open, and they can also be flickers. And they can be an envelope or a frisbee. And opens up, and you have a laptop envelope. So to Noam and everyone else, this tutorial is for you. I forgot to mention I also have an even simpler laptop from $1, a pyramid and eagle laptop, but this one's special for my members only. And for information on memberships, check the description. Okay, on with the show. All right, so for this laptop, I used a 15-inch square of Kami, and this one I used a 6-inch square. But for this tutorial, I'm going to use a 10-inch square. You could use a sheet of printer paper cut square, but then you're not gonna have the contrast, unless of course you draw it on. But if you're gonna draw it on, then you might as well just fold a sheet of paper in half and draw it on, and there's your laptop. So let's begin white side up and fold in half, but we're not actually going to make the whole fold. Just align the corners and make a pinch mark right there. And same on the other side. And unfold. And now fold the corners to the pinch marks. And crease sharply. And rotate and repeat. And now unfold and fold this edge to the crease. And repeat. And now fold this flap up, but don't repeat. So this is 3 layers and this is 2 layers. Okay, now let's fold these 2 flaps up. Now this is a kind of a tricky fold. We're estimating thirds. So what we want is for this area in between to be a square. Once you have it like that, just do your best. Do the same thing on this side. A square in between there. Make those creases nice and sharp and fold over right on the edges. And crease sharply. All right, now let's rotate and repeat on this side. But this time, instead of going in front, we're going to fold the flap behind. So turn over and fold like this. Okay, turn back over. And now we're going to fold in thirds. So estimate that this is equal to this. And you can fold this over and now just align these edges so that the thirds are exact. Just fiddle with the folds. And do the same on this side. And now make the folds nice and sharp. Unfold this flap and unfold this flap. And now you can see we have the screen. And now fold this edge behind. We want to have an equal border for the screen. So if you want to be exact about it, there is a guide mark right there to fold across. But I think that it's good to just fold it to taste so that the borders are equal. So let's turn over, and now when you fold this, naturally there's going to be a little bit of creep here. It's best if you actually make that be a lot of creep, meaning that there's a separation there. So it's like that. Okay, now holding this together so that the separation is still there, unfold and fold it to the crease. So we still have that separation there. And fold up. Okay. So I'm going to turn it over so you see what it looks like. And now we're going to repeat all of that on this side. So you can fold it over, eyeball it, make it equal border. But when you do, you want there to be separation right there. Okay, now holding the separation, unfold and fold the edge to the crease. And fold it over one more time. And now turn over and fold in half. And this is a little tricky because it's quite thick. Just do your best. Okay, so like this, it could be a frisbee or a flicker, or if you want to make it be a flicker in its closed form, then you have to try to stick this whole flap inside this pocket. So like this, it's actually an envelope. A little crumpled, but... So it's an envelope, and it's a laptop. And here I took a lot of time to make the keyboard, but I'm just going to show it to you. Just make a keyboard to taste. So there you have it. Oh, and for this twisty tie dude, I'll have a tutorial on my variety channel coming soon. So, all right, see you guys later. Whoosh.